Testing. It works. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the 13th annual Summer Strings at Lynn University. I'm Shauna St. John. I am the Executive Director of NACU Cold Generator. This year, the 2 weeks have been very exciting. We've had lots of activities. We've had guest artists. I'm sure your kids have been telling you. We've had Palm Beach Symphony. We had Sons of Maestro. We had some people come in and speak about careers in music. It's just been a great, great time. You know, there's always plenty of food and fun, and they've met people from, there's 18 different schools represented up on the stage today throughout the day. And we've had over 100 students. I think this is the most we've ever had attend. It's just been incredible. We also have students in going to third grade, all the way up to seniors, and then there's a few students that are going off to college. It's just an amazing, amazing program. It is our pride and joy. A lot of you have students that have been coming for years and years and years, and we're grateful that they keep coming back and that they're having fun. Let's see, I'm going to go fast. I think really what I want to just say is we're very, very proud of them. And we're grateful that you keep music in their lives and you keep them going and you support them, because you'll see when they're up here, they form friendships. They don't know each other, and they get up here today. And when they're all up here towards the end of the concert, you'll see it's like one complete orchestra. And it's just an incredible feat. So at this time, I'd like to introduce Timlin and Casey Cole, the twin daughters of NACU Cole. They founded this organization. Well, they're going to go into that, but they founded this organization because of budget cuts. And we are so grateful for them for continuing the legacy of their family. And I'm going to actually turn it over to them now.
Good afternoon. Wow, our 13th year. So wonderful seeing you all. We are just overwhelmed with pride and joy for these wonderful, wonderful, talented children. And just going to start by talking about our mission, which is to provide music education to children with the greatest need. Again, this is so much joy in seeing all of the work that they have accomplished this year.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Casey Cole. I'd like to take a moment to thank the people who have supported us. We would never be able to be here without them. Our partners, our donors and supporters, and I'm sure as you can imagine, the cost to produce a program of this quality is quite high. But we are very blessed, we feel, to have wonderful supporters, including the Natalie Cole Foundation, Local West Children's Foundation, the Cultural Council for Palm Beach County, Great Charity Challenge, the Honda Classic Cares, and Palm Beach County Children's Services Council, all who ensure great to provide summer strings every year.
at no cost to our students. We want to thank our in-kind supporters, including Lynn University, the School District of Palm Beach County, Terry Honeycutt, Eat Better, Live Better, Domino's, and Dunkin' Donuts. And finally, the organizations, the musicians, and the professionals who visited and shared their passions with our students. Palm Beach Symphony, Barnes Violins, Sons of Maestro, and our career day professionals, Ricardo Chinchilla, Todd Dahlstrom, Dr. Sharon Gordon-Lane, Dr. Courtney Jones of FAU, and Scotty Rickmans of the On Stage Studios. We congratulate the entire Summer Strings team. Even though they are backstage, we want to acknowledge each and every one of them for their contributions to our program this year. I apologize in advance if I mispronounce any of their names. Let us start with our orchestra teachers, Summer Strings Director Susan Rodberg and Dr. Manuel Capote, Amy Nickler, and Linda Carter-Hemmy. Our Lynn University mentors, Amelia Dixon, Angela Fiedler, Ruvit Braco Marquez, Rosa Ortega, Antoine Rios Palaez, and Cameron Anai Williams. Our volunteers, Terry Honeycutt, Heather Halperin, Christopher Benjamin, Jacqueline Bernstein, Isabel Bernstein, Gavin Chandler, Jordan Galloway, Heather Halperin, Akaise Herring, Terry Honeycutt, I said Terry, Lily McDow, Jolene Mendoza, Iberline Merriman, Hannah Turney, Megan Wilkinson, Music Williams, Annabelle E., and Sarah Zarzur. Our interns were both our Nat and Maria Cole Memorial Scholarship scholars. Aiden Dixon, who just graduated from Stetson and is heading to American University in Washington for his master's degree, and this year's scholar, Olga Guerrero, who will be attending the Howard College in the fall. And of course, our year-round staff, Glenda Leiter, Amy Fruchtman, and our Shama St. John, who, without them, for the dedication and commitment to this program and to our organization. And lastly, we thank you, parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, supporters. We are honored to be sharing this moment with you, and just honored to be surrounded by these talented, wonderful children representing Palm Beach and Broward County. Thank you, and enjoy this wonderful performance.
You're welcome. Go sit and watch and enjoy. Okay. I think I do everything really fast. So at this time, we're going to be calling up our first group. Again, you're going to kind of go in stages from our youngest to our oldest, and also there's, well, you have programs. If you don't have a program, we have some, we can get them to you. So we go from our youngest to our oldest, and then we have our mentors who are amazing. They're all here from Lynn University. We're very honored to be here every year with Lynn University, and they provide incredible talent through their conservatory. So we're very, very grateful to them as well. And I'm gonna go ahead and bring out the next group, and I'm gonna try to move this podium so every parent can see every child. We have every corner of this stage filled with beautiful children. And please enjoy the performance. Thank you.
is, but everybody can hear me, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hi, my name is Miss Steph Lahena.
This is my little Beethoven group. We got these picked last week. We're really excited to show with you guys the four pieces of work we've been doing for camp. We're going to start off with crisscross drag bikes, then we're going to go to roller coaster rock, rock candy, and then finish off with honestly. We hope you guys enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we're on to our last song, but there are more groups to come. So we hope you guys enjoy our last song, Honestly. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, and thank you so much for being here. We are the Simple Gifts Orchestra, kind of a namesake for one of our songs. As we all agree, it's a great name. We like it. The Simple Gifts of Music we will deliver to you today. And they've all worked so hard, and we're all so proud of them. Thank you so much for all your support.
Go, Amy.
Thank you. I Thank you. Thank you. working together for about 13 years in a rapidly moving town. Starting at the top and the eternal gratitude to Casey and Tim and Cole for keeping the dream alive. Also for Sean, I'm glad that everybody else in 2018 to mention, because we keep this going throughout the year. One of the, it changes every year with the starters, with the people, different vendors, different music. One of the things that have sort of grown is that we have students that have been part of it, they're very young, and they've gotten old. It's not cute, but they've gotten old. And what's surprising is that you see their musical maturity from year to year. So rather than turn them away, we've gradually created a group for older veterans, alumni, so to speak. And then they're graduating from college, and then some of the kids from the other groups are eventually people get older and wiser and have become more sophisticated musicians. So, and I'm humbled and blessed to be able to work out some music for them. I think they like most of it. I always like to start with Mozart, then F major divertimento, which is written from very young. It's all original music for strings. It's tricky, but they did very well. The second piece is, we've done before, it's a gentle, Andante Festivo is a gentle single movement, originally written by Sibelius. So this is all, the Mozart is from Austria, and of course, we have in Sibelius, which is of course Finnish. We have Chopin Farewell. It was used as a theme for the Civil War series by Ken Burns, but the piece came first. A Chopin at the Reservoir in the Catskills, and this fiddler, which is another Hope name for violin. Fiddler J. Younger decided to write this piece, thinking about every time they camp in and they have to leave the Chopin. So it's a piece that he wrote, Hope piece, and Ken Burns heard it, and he decided to use it for a Civil War series. So the piece came first, the movie came later, so the theory came first. We'd like to end with something that we've also done before, but it's not a new thing. I like to say the mentors. All these mentors are not really going to want to say it if you feel that they're all right. So, and you may hear about the point of the vision, the mentor music foundation. And Elmer and I came and listened to him in Cuba before COVID. At any rate, the rest of Angela, Ruby, Amelia, Rose was a newbie also. So they're visitors joining the fold, and we hope that they continue contributing their talent. And they have such dedication and devotion to these kids. And I want to give them all a big hand.
Thank you.
to Iraq. So every year we do a chamber music piece. This year we raised the bar just a bit higher, and we're choosing, if any of you know, the Dvorak Bass Quintet. We're just doing the first movement, so don't be alarmed. It's only going to be a small snippet of an entire work, and we hope you enjoy. This is one of the most challenging chamber music pieces to put together due to a lot of unison parts. So we hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
How amazing were they?
So all your kids are going to end up, they keep practicing and they keep playing and they're going to end up
performing like that. And some of them are close, that group just before. There's high school students, I mean 9th grade, 10th grade, 11th grade, the group before Dr. Capote's group. Good. Amazing. And I love the tango, I always want to dance. We have one more performance for you, and while they're getting ready in the wings and stuff, I have a couple things, some housekeeping things, and some people to thank. But first, everyone who has a program on your program book, you have all of our social media, Facebook, Instagram, all the things we have. Please, we're going to be putting photos. We've been live streaming on Facebook today, so I'm sure it saves and then it lives somewhere on a cloud in our Facebook. So please enjoy that. And then we've been taking photos for the whole 2 weeks, so we'll be sending those photos to the teachers and we'll be posting them in different places as well. So please take a look. Also on the back of your program, there's a little code. If you are able to and you feel like it, please take a chance to donate to our program. Not only do we have this program, we have another camp that we're doing in Chicago this summer, a summer jazz camp. We do a Music Educators National Teachers Conference that we do. We repair and place instruments throughout the schools in our area. I think there might even be some of the instruments that we repaired on this stage today. We were very invested in making sure that all children have access to music education, so we try to layer our programs so they all complement each other. This year we had a Mentors in Schools program at two elementary schools in Palm Beach County, and some of the mentors were here. We're actually going into the classrooms the entire last semester in the school. So all up here and they're all going to play. It's just so amazing. I don't want to ruin that feeling right after. So I want to thank our board of directors. I want to thank my amazing staff, the staff I have in the office that we work, I don't know, are there only 365 days a year? I think there are more and we work them all. All of the directors and the teachers and the mentors and the volunteers and the just everyone that's here, and some of your kids who are not here as mentors, they're mentoring the student next to them. We're all about everyone working together and becoming one amazing group that performs for you. And I think they're pretty darn good. And then, you know, as Tim Ellen and Casey said, the parents, we want to thank all the parents and all people that are here. If you're here to support a child, we applaud you. Thank you for being here. It's important. And you're doing a great job. So the last thing is dismissal instructions. This is like the housekeeping stuff. If your child rides on the UBK bus, when you leave the theater, you're going to turn left and you have to sign your child out. They're going to be in the black box. You'll be able to tell because there'll be a big crowd waiting for the kids to come out. You cannot take them without signing them out. If your child rides on the Plumosa bus, you're going to go out and you're going to turn right, and they're in that room. Many of you probably walk past it. It's the room that has all the windows. So that's where your children are going to be in there. Also, if you are your child is a parent pickup, that's the room where they're going to be as well. We're not going to lose them. They're going to be here. You know, you're going to have to take a little bit of time to pick them up. And then also, we would like to thank all of the organizations that gave in kind to us. We had a new partner this year called Eat Better, Live Better, and they provide healthy snacks for children. And they graciously donated snacks for all of the children every day for 2 weeks. We have some leftover. We don't like leftover food. So we've got it over here in the food area. You may have seen some of it. But please take some home, stuff the backpacks full. We really don't want the food to go to waste. So feel free to take whatever it is you want and you can use. And if you know someone that you can give it to, please take it. And some of the snacks were really good this year. We had a lot of fruit. You guys would be very happy. And some chips too. And some Rice Krispie treats, and they ate them all and I didn't get any, but I'll have to get my own, I guess. I mean, the donors and the sponsors and the volunteers and people who come to our events and anyone who does anything for us, it's for them. So we're very, very grateful. And I think that's it. I'm going to turn it over to Mrs. Rodberg. Oh, there she is. And please enjoy. Oh, so this song, I don't, were you going to introduce it? You want me to do it? Okay, you're going to do it? You want me to do it? Okay, I'll do it. Every year we try to come up with a really great song as the last song. We've done Unforgettable, and we've done a couple other songs, but this year, this one's a little special because it is the one song that Nat King Cole actually wrote. So we're doing this in honor of the family of Nat King Cole. I think, Justin, are you still up there? Yes. So in honor of them and all they do for us and for these kids, we put this song together, and Ms. Rocco did an incredible job, as always, every year. So thank you. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Awesome.